And when we go through the bushes, we find a lot of the pineapples in the bushes as well. Yes, so.
Okay. Yes, my brother, we have friends on Facebook and all over the network.
Okay.
Our goal is to educate our brothers and sisters about the real history of what Wadamta ancestors.
So you see, during that era, sometimes when I see these big trees, it reminds me of the oral history that was made by one of our elders who passed on. He said when they were marching from the Salaga market to Asimanso slave market, during that era in Africa, we were having all sorts of wild animals. We have the leopard, the lions, the mambas. We were having all sorts of wild animals. So while they were passing through the forest, the animals also wanted them to feed on. So they had a way of putting the animals back so that they don't attack our enslaved Africans and those people. Yes. Yes.
Blue-eyed.
Stolen from Africa. And another one I have for you, stolen African.
Stolen African.
We're trying to use words to link. Yeah, that,
captives.
Yes. Stolen Africans and captives. All of those are relative terms.
So do you know what they did? When they are walking in the line and they find out that one of our stolen African is weak and cannot continue with the journey, they bring him or her out of the chain and they tie him around any big tree they find in the forest just for him or her to perish. Mm-hmm. And so when they leave the person behind and the animals start tracing the feet of our people, when he sees those people, he feeds on those people. After feeding, they become satisfied and they don't chase the rest. Mm. So those are some of the, so I wanted to use the
evil atrocity.
Yes, so those are some of the evil atrocity that was committed on our ancestors and brothers and sisters as well.
Yeah, so let people know that they have to be careful so no one eats them.
So these are some of the pineapples.
Yes, brother, so you're the new powerful voice of education around here. I love it, man. Yeah, so we're working as a pack together to make sure that this information stays documented. Yeah. And that no one does say that we just got on luxury ships and went to America to be workers to build America.
Yeah.
Yeah. So all these videos we've done over the years helped a whole lot.
Right.
Especially when we were linking the stolen Africans, the captives, and those things to the real sense of what really happened. Because in America, a lot of people wonder, how did we get over here? How did this happen? And so this is like when I was in high school or junior high school, even in university, none of this information that we're doing right now was ever told to any of us about how the ancestors marched down from the northern region, how they were washed up at a Sin Manso and things like that. So just be here and document it, and for yourself who've been passed on the good oral history, it's powerful. And I know a lot of times I come twice a year or so and record the same videos, but I also tell people it's a different angle. And you know, we also see the new energy of people in the videos.
Yeah. Very, very important with what you're doing.
Yes, and family, Sister Sass. The famous Sister Sass.
Taken this trek many times, but something about this time.
And Sister Sass and myself and Pepe got a whole lot of surprises for folks as far as our repatriation movement as our crew together.
Our ancestors.
And we're going to keep that secret until we share with you all the wonderful things that we're going to be doing.
Holy ground.
With our brother Kojo Asasifo. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
The brother's been a beautiful light. Yes, family, we are
poor libations.
Walking through the ancestral.
Mm-hmm. At the one point.
A river.
It's just in Nigeria.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and
okay, so basically this is small gossip, which is also very important for our tour. Yes, you'll be wondering why in this forest we have people living closer, the communities living closer. Yes,